Welcome everyone. Now we are going to see about different databases for chemical structures and chemical informations like Drug Bank, PubChem, NPAS and NPACT. Okay, let's see the information about the Drug Bank. Now we are going to see about Drug Bank and how to browse for structures in the Drug Bank and how to download structures for docking purpose from the Drug Bank. So now we are going to the Drug Bank website now. So this is the Drug Bank database. Do the Google search and click on this go.drugbank.com and you will go to the Drug Bank website. In the Drug Bank website, if you want information about specific drugs, you can search for the specific drugs in the search box given. For example, now I'm going to search for Tylenol itself. This is the acetaminophen. Here you can find the details. Here you can find the details on the left side. If you want pharmacology, toxicity, interactions, products, categories, chemical identifiers, references, clinical trials, and pharmacoeconomics, properties, and spectral data also. Here you find various spectral data and targets for this particular drug. And targets for this particular drugs are also given, and enzymes, carriers and transporters, everything is given for the specified drugs. If you want, you can also search for a new drug. Okay, now we are going to see how to download the structures. If you want individual structures, you can download this page itself. If you want individual structures, you can download here. On the identification, click on background and click on here download. You can download in various formats. You can download in 3D structure also, or you can find the similar structures. That's how you download. If you want in PDB format, you can click on PDB and you will come the PDB format. Click on download and right click on PDB and click on save link as. If you click on save link as, in the molecule will download as a PDB format. You can right click on the PDB and click on save link as, and you will download as a PDB format. Okay, now if you want many structures, or if you want all the structures, all the approved structures, you can go to the downloads and go to the structures, and you can download all the approved drugs, okay, in the STF format. Or if you want an experimental structures, all the experimental drugs, you can click on download this one. Or if you want withdrawn drugs or investigational drugs, illicit, you can download the respective files here. But before downloading these files, you need to create a free account. After creating the free account, log into the account. After that, you have to download the structures. Not only structures, you can also download many informations such as external drug links and protein identifiers, drug target identifiers and target sequences in the FASTA format. These are the drug target sequences in the FASTA format and drug sequences. This also in the FASTA format. Okay, you have to log in first. You have to provide the email ID and password. After that, you have to click on sign in and you can download the respective files. If you don't have an account here, you should sign up for an account. So provide the details here. Okay, after providing, you have to click on sign up and login, and you can download the structures. So that's all. Next, we are going to see about how to download structures from the PubChem website. So go to the PubChem website now. So PubChem database or PubChem. Go to the PubChem website. So the PubChem website is now loading. After loading, okay, now the PubChem website is loaded. You can find so many information in the PubChem website, like small molecules and macromolecules, nucleotides and chemically modified nucleotides are also available. So now we are going to explore the. So in the PubChem website, there are so many ways to search. First, we are going to search by drawing the structures, or you can upload the ID list and you can download that complete list of structures, or you can browse for the data, or you can download the periodic table or see information about the periodic table. Now we are going to the draw structures. Here you find the drawing tools. Using these tools you can draw for the structures and you can search for that complete structures, or you have, or you can upload the ID list, PubChem ID list. After uploading the PubChem ID list, you can download the complete list. Here you have to choose the compound ID list or a SID or a compound ID, and then you enter the identifiers separated by comma or space, or you can upload the file containing the complete IDs, or you can just browse for the data, or you can go for the periodic table and see the periodic table itself. So this is the periodic table with the chemical group block. You can see the various formats: oxidation states, electronegativity, atomic radius, ionization, etc. Okay. If you want an single structures, like if you want, here you can find the compounds, substances, pathways, biases, literatures, and patents. If you want information about the compound, you have to click on compounds. You have to click any compound. Now the information about the compound is loaded. On the right side, you can find the table of contents. Like here you find title and summary structures, names and identifiers, like that, chemical and physical properties, spectral information, and some other related records, chemical vendors and drug and medication information, pharmacology and manufacturing, identification, safety hazards, toxicity, and so many other information are all available. If you want to download the structures, go to the structure and you can click on this download button on the right side. Okay, you can find the various formats. SDF, you can save in the SDF format. Here you can download the in the SDF format. Next we are going to see about how to download data and structures from the NPAS database. So go to the NPAS database, NPAS or NPAS database. This database is for natural products, natural product activity and species source database. So that is the expansion for the NPAS, natural product activity and species source database. Here you can browse for the structures or you can search for the structures. So here are some data available: 25,000 source organisms and 35,000 natural products and 5,800 biological targets and 446,000 activity records. So if you want to download structures from the NPAS database, here is the download button. Okay, below the search button, below the search button you have the download button. You can click on this download button. Here are the information available, so you can download. If you want structures for a docking purpose, this is the natural product structures. Okay, these are in the STF format and compressed with the RAR or ZIP format. Okay, you can either download the RAR format or ZIP format. When you extract these files, you get the STF format. In the STF format, you will have the natural product structures. Okay, this is approximately 22 MB in size. If you want general information, you can download here. Or physicochemical properties, you can download this file. Okay, if you want the species source, you can download here, and target informations and species taxonomic informations are available here. So if you want to browse for some informations, natural product chemical taxonomy and list of initial natural products name. If you want to browse by molecular weight range, you can browse here. So if you want 300 to 350 range natural products, click here and you will find the list here. This is the ID and name, formula and some other properties. So this is the information about the NPAS databases. This is the outline of the NPAS database. If you want any help, you can click on help. and see the topics and see the help topics. Next, we are going to see about the database NPACT database. This database is mainly used for the anti-cancer compounds. Now we are going to see the NPACT database. So this is the website for the NPACT database. So this NPACT is a curated database of plant-derived natural compounds. This is mainly for the anti-cancer activity. This contains more than 1500 entries. For each compounds, they provide the experimentally determined inhibitory values such as IC50, ED50, EC50 and GI50. Okay. This also provides information on the in vivo experiments as well as the protein targets that have been demonstrated in the cancer cell lines. At present, the database contains over 1980 experimentally validated compound drug interactions. Okay, how to use this? Now we are going to browse the structures. Here you can filter the compounds based on many criteria. You can filter the compound based on the alphabetical order or based on the cancer type. You can, if you want compounds for the lung cancer, you can click here, lung cancer. Or if you want compounds which act against the specific cell lines, you can click here. Okay, you can select the specific cell line. If you want the target name, if you want the compounds against the specific targets, you can select the targets here. If you want to filter the compounds based on the chemical class, you can click here. For example, flavonoids, this is the epicatechin, gallocatechin, these are the flavonoid compounds. Now this one has the in vitro anti-cancer activity. This is against one cancer cell line. And whether it has in vivo anti-cancer activity? Yes, it has in vivo anti-cancer activity. So what are the cell lines this epicatechin inhibits? The cell lines is provided here, cancerous connective tissues, and the reference are given here. So that's all. If you want, you can filter using the suppliers also. If you need any help, you can go to help and FAQs. If you have any doubts, please post in the comment section. And if you like this video, please subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching.